Welcome to Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation's Virtual Training Center. And I am Mrs. Nehal Kodambe, your English teacher from VTC. Let's begin with today's session.
Welcome to today's English session. See, dear children, whenever we are starting learning standard 10th course book since June, we have gone through many inspirational poems that is meant for teenagers, that is of your group, right? Now you all are in teens. Somebody may be 17, somebody may be 16. So your age group is called teenage group. And we have seen in the very first poem, A Teenager's Prayer, what a boy of your age is praying to the God, right? Then we have seen one more very nice poem, You Start Dying Slowly by Pablo Neruda. In that poem also, poet has given you some message through his very poetic way that how should be at this very agey age of your life. Then there was a poem of Basket Full of Moonlight. In that poem, we have seen that how the people of certain age or certain age group, they have to face certain thing during their age group. So you can remember here one thing, whatever prose or poems are there which we are going through or which we are learning, that those poems they have selected very thoughtfully, that through these poems, through these prose passages, we get some or the other message. Now, why I'm mentioning these poems? Because A Teenager's Prayer or You Start Dying Slowly, these poems are specially made for your age group. And in 9th standard also, you have learned one poem, Please Listen, right? In that poem also, the boy of your age or the child of your age is requesting parents to listen to him. He has to say something to his parents. So, my dear children, at this age, that parent and child bonding should be there. So that at this age, our parents only can guide us or they can show us the right path of our life, because this world is full of opposites. We have seen that in 9th standard, a very beautiful poem, Comparison, that this world is full of plus and minuses. People are there to grudge you, they are there to blame you, they are there to bring you down. But your parents, they are always wishing you the best should come in your life. So in today's session also, why I mentioned all these poems? Because in today's session also, we are going to learn a very beautiful and inspiring poem. After learning this poem, I hope or I'm sure that your relation with your parents, they are going to change. It is going to change. Okay. So after learning this poem, if you get a chance or if you keep that type of relation with your parents, then please explain this poem to them also. And try to have a good friend within your, especially within or with your father. So let's see which poem is that and what message the poet has given through this poem. So the title of the poem is If, only that much, If. But this smallest word has the biggest meaning. So this poem is written by very famous poet Rudyard Kipling. So in today's session, we are going to learn this poem by Rudyard Kipling. So let's begin with the poem, If, by Rudyard Kipling. Now before starting the poem, we will have short information. We will read about the poet who has brought such a beautiful poem for us. So, Here is the poet Rudyard Kipling, born in 1965 and was died in 1936. Rudyard Kipling was an English journalist, short story writer, poet and novelist. See, in his life he has performed so many roles. He was an English journalist, that means he used to write in newspaper, short story writer, poet and novelist too. Kipling was one of the most popular writers in the United Kingdom in both prose and verse in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1907 at the age of 42. See, you can see his achievement. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for the Literature in 1907. And the most remarkable achievement is that he was the first writer writing in English to receive the prize. Okay, so that was about our today's poem, poet Rudyard Kipling. And what is the special feature of this poem? See, whenever you can, you will look at this picture, you will come to know that this poem, if deals with advice given by father to his son. What is the central theme or idea of this poem? This poem deals with advice given by father to his son. As I told you earlier in the introduction, that father or our parents, they are our friends, they are our guide, they are our philosopher. So you have to believe upon them. And you should follow the path which is shown by them. So in this poem, the central idea of this poem is that advice given by father to his son. So we will begin with the poem. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. See here, what father is advising to his son? If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. See dear children, you may find many new phrases in this poem because this poem is written by the poet who is from United Kingdom, right? So here we will refer to the glossary column whenever we find any new phrase. Okay, now let's see the meaning of these lines. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing there and blaming it on you, means what? That remain calm when everyone near you is not calm. Okay, they are blaming you and they are holding you responsible for the problems. Then you should have confidence that you are acting correctly when everyone thinks you are wrong. And at the same time, understand their doubts also. What poet is telling us here through the father, what father is asking his son to, that if you can keep your head when all about you, keep your head means you should be calm. Don't overreact. Keep yourself calm. Try to keep yourself calm. I know this is very difficult thing, but it is not impossible also. If you can keep yourself calm, when everywhere around you are holding you responsible for the problems. They are blaming you means they are holding you responsible for the problem. At this situation, you should have confidence that whatever and however you are acting, you are doing it correctly. And when everyone thinks you are wrong, at that time you should have faith upon yourself that whatever things I am doing, however I am doing it correctly. And at the same time, understand their doubts too. Father is telling to his son that whenever people are blaming you, they are taking doubt upon you, keep yourself calm, try to be calm, cool, okay? But at the same time, you know when you are acting correctly, but at the same time think little why they are taking doubt on you, why they are doubting you. You think for that too. Next, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating. And yet, don't look too good, nor talk too wise. My God, what an advice given by father to his son. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting, that means you should have lot of patience. Okay? Or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or you are being hated by the people, don't give way to hating, don't give yourself hated by them. And yet, don't look too good, nor talk too wise. In this situation also, don't try to look too good and not to talk too wise also. Means what? We will see once again. Be patient in every situation. Okay, have patience in every situation and can tolerate lies being told about you. I know you are not lying. Tu khota bolat nahi. I know that. But be patient. If somebody is blaming you that this boy or he is lying, he is a liar, in that situation, be patient. Don't overreact. And in the same situation, don't being hated too. Don't hate them. Not hate anybody yourself. Not try to look or sound too good. In this situation also, if people are blaming you that you are a liar, whatever words are said by you, they are proving it to be lie. But in this situation also, try to be patient. Have patience with you. And one thing is that don't be hated and don't hate anyone. But in this situation also, I'm asking you to be patient, don't hate anyone and don't get hated by anyone. And in this situation also, don't look too good or nor talk too wise also. Means what? Not try to look or sound too good. Vadil tyancha mulala kay sangtay? की तुला लोकांनी खोटं ठरवलं, तू खोटं बोलतोयस, तू चुकीचं वागतोयस, ठीक आहे, ओव्हर रिॲक्ट होऊ नकोस. तुला माहिती आहे ना तू बरोबर आहेस, तुला माहिती आहे ना तू खोटं बोलत नाही आहेस, ठीक आहे, पेशन्स ठेव, शांतपणे ती सिच्युएशन हँडल कर. एकच आहे की त्यांचा द्वेष करू नको किंवा कोणाचा द्वेष करून घेऊ सुद्धा नकोस. पण या सिच्युएशनमध्ये मी तुला एक सल्ला देईन की अशा लोकांबरोबर अति चांगलं किंवा मी खूप शाणा आहे हे दाखवण्याचा पण प्रयत्न करू नको. बी व्हॉट एव्हर यू आर, तू जसा आहेस तसा तू उत्तम आहेस. नेक्स्ट स्टॅन्झा, इफ यू कॅन ड्रीम अँड नॉट मेक ड्रीम्स युअर मास्टर, इफ यू कॅन थिंक अँड नॉट मेक थॉट्स युअर एम, इफ यू कॅन मीट विथ ट्रायम्फ अँड डिझास्टर अँड ट्रीट दोज टू इम्पोस्टर्स जस्ट द सेम. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same. Means what? What father is telling to his son? You dream. Okay, dreaming is not bad. Everyone dreams. Some people even they do daydreaming also. Dream, but not just dream, just don't do dream. Instead, be realistic and be goal oriented. Whatever your dreams are, try to chase them. You work hard and try to achieve those things about which you are dreaming. Okay? Try to be realistic and be goal oriented. Function in both good situation and bad also. Triumph and disaster means good and bad situation, and realize that you will have both throughout your life. Triumph and disaster means victory or any event that causes great damage to. Hani ani labh mhanto apan tasa. What father is telling to his son? If you can dream and not make dreams your master. Okay? Yes, you should dream. You have full right for dreaming yourself. But don't make dreams your master. Just don't dream and sleep. But try hard to chase your dreams. Make it in reality. So you can think and not make thoughts your aim. Try to chase your aim. Whatever things you have to achieve in your life, you work hard for achievement of those dreams. If you can be triumph and disaster and treat those imposters just the same. In life, some days are good, some days are bad. But don't get panic in all the situations. You should be able to handle both the situation correctly, calmly, in cool manner, because this is life. All days are not sunny days. Okay? So in your life, there may be sometimes triumph or sometimes disaster too. And you treat all, both the situation in equal manner. वडील मुलाला सांगतात की स्वप्न बघ, तुला पूर्ण अधिकार आहे स्वप्न बघायचा, पण स्वप्न पूर्ण करायला तुला कष्ट केले पाहिजे. तुझ्या मनात जे विचार चालले आहेत ते विचार सत्यात उतरवायला तू कष्ट कर, तू प्रयत्न कर. आयुष्यामध्ये चांगले आणि वाईट दोन्ही प्रकारचे दिवस येतात आणि त्या दोन्ही सिच्युएशन मध्ये तू स्वतःला कूल ठेवून त्या दोन्ही सिच्युएशन योग्य प्रकारे सारख्या प्रकारे हँडल करायला सक्षम हो. नेक्स्ट, इफ यू कॅन बेअर टू हिअर द ट्रुथ यू हॅव स्पोकन, ट्विस्टेड बाय नेव्स टू मेक अ ट्रॅप फॉर फूल्स, और वॉच द थिंग्स यू गेव युअर लाईफ टू ब्रोकन अँड स्टॉप अँड बिल्ड देम अप विथ वॉर्न आउट टूल्स. मीन्स वॉट? If you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools. See, those lines are very important and it has a great meaning. Even you must have gone through this situation. What father is telling to his son, that you learn. What you have to learn? That if you can bear to hear whatever truth you have spoken, but some people have twisted your words, they have put in the way they want or wrecked your projects, isn't it? Then you have to rebuild them up again with the necessary nails, right? What father is telling to his son, that even if sometimes you have spoken some words, but there are nails. Nails means cunning people, okay? Or dishonest people, they are trying to trap you. Within, how they are trying to trap you? By twisting your words. But in this situation, what you have to do, watch the things you gave your life to broken and stop and build them up with worn out tools. Though people are trying to trap you, they have twisted your words, they are blaming you, you are a liar, you are a loser. But in this situation, try to be strong. Try to face this situation. And if they are trying to break you, if the things in your life are broken, just don't break yourselves. You stop there and try to build them again with worn out tools. You try to be with new tools. Okay? आयुष्यात असे भोंदू, असे लबाड लोक आपल्याला भेटतात. एखादी गोष्ट आपण जी बोललेली असते त्याचा विपर्यास करतात, वेगळा अर्थ लावतात. पण अशा सिच्युएशनमध्ये आपण मूर्ख न बनता, एखादी गोष्ट आपल्या हातून निसटली असेल किंवा ते काढून हिसकावून घेण्याचा प्रयत्न करत असतील, तर आपल्यामध्ये तेवढी क्षमता निर्माण कर की तू तुला पाहिजे तसं साम्राज्य, तुला पाहिजे तसं तू तुझ्या जे काही गोल्स ठरवले आहेस ते पुन्हा उभे करू शकशील. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue or walk with kings nor lose the common touch. See, read these lines again. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue or walk with kings nor lose the common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you. If all men count with you but none too much. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue or walk with kings nor lose the common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much. What poet, what father tells to his son? That resist being corrupted by ordinary people. Common crowd is ordinary people, okay? Crowd of ordinary people. Or by people in high position. Kings here means people in high position. Not to be hurt by either enemies or friends. Foes means enemies. Or by friends. Value everyone, but not anyone personally too much. What father is advising his son? If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, if you are following or if you are gathered by ordinary people, you are corrupted by ordinary people or by people in high position, what you have to do is that you shouldn't get hurt by either of your enemies or your friends. But one thing is that value everyone, okay? But not any one person too much. Your father is advising son ki tu jeva ordinary manasan barobar samanya lokan barobar as kiwa high post cha manasan barobar as kona barobar kadu nahi samja tu hurt jhalayas kiwa tula kai tari yuvatanni manipulate kele pan asha situation madhe kiwa tuje shatru ahe tuje mitra ahe kona kadu nahi tu hurt honar nahis itka swatala strong banav. Don't give anybody to hurt you. Don't give anyone to right of hurting you. All men count with you. Give value, give importance to everybody. Though they are poor, though they are rich, though they are ordinary people, though they are high position people, but don't allow anyone to come too close. Sagyanbarobar sarkha raha. Either ordinary manus asu de kiwa high post varcha asu de. पण एक लक्षात घे तुझे मित्र असू दे तुझे शत्रू असू दे सगळ्यांबरोबर चांगला राहा पण कोणालाही तुझा अति जवळ करू नको. सी माय डियर चिल्ड्रन दिस इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट विच वी हैव टू फॉलो थ्रू आउट अवर लाइफ एट दिस एज एट दिस स्लिपरी एज ऑफ युअर लाइफ यू शुड Listen to this advice given by a father to his son is mean to each and every one of your age. Okay? Let's move to the next translation. See here. If you can feel the unforgiving minutes with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And which is more, you will be a man, my son. What father is telling to his son? If you can feel the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And which is more, you will be a man, my son. Father is telling his son that make the most of every minute of life. And then you will be an honorable and trustworthy human being. See, you have dream. And as I told you, you should chase your dream. And while chasing your dream, you have to work hard for the every second of your life. And see, my son, if you follow my advice, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. We say that, dunya apni mutthi mein. So if you work hard, you will achieve whatever you have dreamed for, and which is more, you will be a man, my son. A man means you will be a trustworthy human being. You will get a great respect from the society. So here in this poem, a father is advising his son how to behave the people in this world and how to be strong on yourself. Try to be friendly with everyone, but don't let anyone to get too close to you. Okay? So that's what we have learned in this poem. Now we will read. I have written the meaning of these lines for you in simple language. Let's read it once. See first four lines. If you can keep your head when all about you and losing their and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you but make allowance for their doubtings too, Actually, I have explained this to you, but let's read it once so that you can understand it very well. Remain calm. As I told you, calm in every situation, cool in every situation. When everyone near you is not calm and they are holding you responsible for the problem, have confidence that you are acting correctly when everyone thinks you are wrong, and at that time understand their doubts. Okay? Next lines. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good nor talk too wise. Read the meaning. Be patient and can tolerate lies being told about you. I know you don't lie, and being hated. Not hate anybody yourself. Don't allow anybody to hate yourself. Don't hate anybody and not try to look or sound also. Next lines. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same. Dream, but not just dream. Instead, be realistic and be good, goal-oriented. Function in both good situations and bad, and realize that you will have both throughout your life. As I told you, this is life. All days are not sunny days. Okay? So in all the situations, you have to be calm and learn how to handle both the situations. Triumph and disaster means victory or an event that causes you great damage. Next, if you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stop and build them up with worn out tools. Tolerate the fact that people have twisted your words or wrecked your projects, but rebuild your projects and rebuild your life again when necessary. Don't be a loser in your life, because the world around us is not so goody-goody, right? If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you but none too much. Simple meaning. Resist being corrupted by ordinary people or by people in high positions. Kings means people in high positions. Not to be hurt by either enemies or friends. Value everyone, but not any one person too much. Don't give importance to any single person. Be equal to everyone. If you can feel the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you will be a man, my son. That is the last stanza. Father is telling his son, make the most of every minute of life. That is, work hard for the every minute, 60 seconds every minute. Then you will be an honorable and trustworthy human being. Okay? So, my dear children, here we have finished learning this very beautiful poem by Rudyard Kipling. I hope you have understood this poem. Now, there is a simple activity. So, here are two questions from our workshop. Very important question. Answer briefly. The first question, I'll read it for you. What should be our attitude towards people of different strata and classes? Different strata means different level. How we should behave with the people of different level and classes through our society? And second question is, What, according to Rudyard Kipling, is the highest quality that makes a man a true human being? See, dear children, after explaining the poem, again we have written the meaning in very simple words. So you go through this video and find out the answer of this question. Is that okay for you? So I hope this poem is not just for answering question or learning only for standard 10. But if you learn this poem again and again, you write it this poem on a paper and you stick it in front of your eyes. Wherever you will see the poem, you will follow the advice given by the father to his son. And you will gain that confidence how to behave the people in our society. Okay? So be brave, be strong, and be on yourself.
That's all for today. So you will revise whatever we have learned in today's session. Please subscribe the channel and press the notification button to get the link of next video. Bye-bye.